Well, my name is Peter Preiser, and I am from Germany originally, and now I am in Singapore at the Nanyang Technological University, where I have a couple of positions. I'm the Associate Provost for Graduate Education, which means I'm responsible for all PhDs and master students at the university. And I'm also the Chair of the School of Biological Sciences. And I run a research project on malaria, and I'm mainly interested in host pathogen interactions. Well, in MaHPIC, my role is actually as an advisor, so I'm not actually involved in any of the direct research going on, but I'm supposed to advise the scientists in the project and give feedback based on the own experiences that we have in the research we do. There's quite a lot of overlap, and I guess this is why I'm playing a role here as an advisor in the things that we do. And so today, again, it's just about listening to what is being done and trying to help them along to do things a little bit better, if that's possible at all. Well, I think the big advantage of MaHPIC is that it is really trying to put a fully integrated approach into looking at important questions of malaria pathology and disease development. It combines really a wide diversity of expertise, so not just people working on malaria, but people who are working on computational biology, who bring in a lot of different technology platforms. I think also one of the real big advantages is the fully integrative approach that MaHPIC takes by combining genomics, transcriptomics, proteomics, metabolomics in most likely the best models we have for human pathology, which are the primate systems, and trying to integrate the data. A lot of the data that is out there is sort of single studies, you know, either transcriptome or proteome. Here, everything is put together. That has the potential of creating fantastic new insights into parasite biology, which in the future will have the potential to lead into better interventions and better understanding of the parasite biology. Another big advantage is that by integrating all the data, you are creating a really much better understanding of all the factors that contribute to disease outcome. Now that's challenging, and I think this is the team that they put together is most likely best suited to actually address this because of the different expertise available. How did I get interested in malaria? That's a kind of interesting story. I actually did my PhD on Drosophila genetics, so fruit fly. I did a postdoc on splicing in human cells. And then I was about to move back from the United States, where I had done all this, to Europe. And I had three opportunities. One was to work on viruses and at the University of Würzburg, one was to work on cancer at the German Cancer Center, and the other one was to go to London and start working on malaria. And that was quite a challenging decision to make, so I decided I was going to travel around the world a little bit, and I spent 2 months in Southeast Asia, and I was sitting on a beach in Bali, and I decided, I was thinking, if I work on malaria, there might be an opportunity to go back to working sometimes in the tropics. And that is how I started getting into malaria. And I also hadn't lived in London before. So London sounded as an attractive place to move to, and the fact that it is a tropical disease. So there, at that stage, I was 27 years old. There was no big thought about, But there is one other issue, and I always felt when I was talking to my parents at the breakfast table, what do you do? And I said, I'm working on a fruit fly, so why is that important? And it gets a little bit awkward when I said as well, I work on malaria, kills millions of people every year. It's so much easier to justify to your parents about this. What I would say, why would anyone want to work on malaria or in these areas is, I think there are a number of reasons. One of it, I think, is it's just a really exciting biological system. Forget about how its impact on health, but really it is one of these fantastic systems which is really confounding scientists. So there is, if you want to really go out there and be challenged intellectually, this is the way to go. The other thing is, obviously, it is a real health problem. So you're working on something that has real impact if you do something. in it and move the field along. And, you know, like, if you understand or start working on malaria and working on these the projects that are like developed at MaPAC, you know, you can translate that information to any other system. So you're not stuck in malaria in the long run. You can go and say, this is, you know, this is a challenge. The thing that I can learn from this, I can translate into other fields. And I think this is always the important thing to remember for someone starting off as a research scientist, is the project you work on as a PhD student or a postdoc does not mean is what you have to do for the rest of your life. I think what is really fantastic about MaPAC is the integration of different fields. You know, that they have really reached out to get the best people rather than just sticking in the field of who does something in malaria. They've gone out and tried to get the best people available. The fact that it's really international, research in all these areas is now a global effort. It's interdisciplinary and it's international, and it's very important that the mechanisms are put in place to allow this to happen. You know, you always hear, you know, you have to work interdisciplinary and you have to work global, but often there are no mechanisms of actually really making this happen in terms of funding opportunities, etc. Here now you have something in place which is at least starting to really go out international.